morning, everybody, on this rainy morning in my country. It's raining, cats and dogs. Good morning, happy Saturday. Happy saturated Saturday to you all. I hope you all having a good day in America and Caribbean, right? But we have any Bible study today still, despite the rain outside. Rain is good, that is abundance, blessings, favor, mercies, and grace. Because God is good all the time, God is good. I hope you all have all your reading materials and writing materials, the King James Version, your Bible, right? And you can take down notes if you want, or you can watch me on replay. But God is so good all the time, God is good, okay? So let us pray, and then we are going on to Psalms 86, 1 to 17, and also Acts 15, 1 to 41, Bible study, okay? And then we are going to do Bible study summary today also. So I hope you enjoy this whole video, but let us pray. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this day, Father Lord. We thank you for life, health, and strength, Father Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus, wherever people are in the world, Father Lord, that wherever they're listening to me, Father Lord, it will be a blessing to their hearts, Father Lord. Father Lord, I thank you, Lord Jesus, to come into your presence every single day of my life and give a word for your people, Father Lord, and saints of God, Father Lord. I pray that, Father, it will uplift, inspire, motivate, Father Lord, them to encourage them to go draw more closer to the Lord and stop studying this world and its wicked ways. Father Lord, yes, we are in the world, but not of the world, Father Lord, but Lord, we need to mean what we say, Father Lord, and say what I mean, Father Lord. So I'm about to bring your word, Father Lord, about him in your Bible study, Father Lord, summary, and your powerful word, Father Lord, that the Holy Spirit will saturate this atmosphere in America, in Caribbean, Father Lord. So I'm about to bring every single thing into your care, Father Lord. You, Father Lord, take control and charge of this video, Father Lord. You take over this video, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father Lord. Amen. Okay, so I'm looking very, very good today. Okay. So just hold on one minute. Hold on one minute. Okay, hold on. Sorry about that. Okay, so we are going on to Psalms in the Amplified Bible. Psalms 86, 1 to 17, right? And this is very, 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 very serious right now. Okay, God is speaking to us. Okay, so Psalms 86, right, 1 to 17. Let us read. Okay. Incline your ear, O Lord, and answer me, for I am poor and distressed, needy, and desiring. Preserve my life, for I am godly and dedicated. O my God, save your servant, for I trust in you, leading and believing on you. Committing all and confidently looking to you without fear or doubt. Be merciful and gracious to me, O Lord, for to you do I cry all the day. Make me your servant to rejoice, O Lord, for you too I lift myself up. For you, O Lord, are good and ready to forgive our trespasses, sending away, letting them go completely and forever. And you are abundantly in mercy and loving kindness to all those who call upon you. Give ear, O Lord, to my prayer and listen to the cry of my supplications. In the day of my trouble, I will call on you, for you will answer me. None like unto you among the gods, O Lord, neither are there works like unto yours.
Verse 9. All nations whom you have made shall come and fall down before you, O Lord, and they shall glorify your name. For you are great and work wonders, you alone are God. Teach me your way, O Lord, that I may walk and live in your truth. Direct and unite my heart solely, reverently to fear and honor your name. Psalms 5:11-39-36. I will confess and praise you, O Lord, my God, with my whole united heart, and I will glorify your name forevermore. For great is your mercy and loving kindness toward me, and you have delivered me from the depths of Sheol. Right? From exceeding depth of affliction, O God, the proud and insolent are risen against me. The rabble of violent and ruthless men have sought after and demanded my life and have not set you before them. But you, O Lord, are a God and merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in mercy and loving kindness and truth. O turn to me and have mercy and be gracious to me, O Lord. Grant strength, might, and inflexibility to temptation to your servants and your saints of God, O Lord. And save the son of all your handmaiden. Last verse. I want people to hear it in the back, in the front, in the side. Okay? Show me a sign of your evident goodwill and favor that those who hate me may see it and be put to shame, because you, O Lord, will show your approval of me when you help and comfort me. So I hope, Father Lord, I pray that, Father Lord, Psalms 86:1-70 will be a blessing to the people's hearts, in the name of Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen. So God is saying in Psalm 86, we need to focus, we need to forgive, right? We need to let go and let God, and give ear unto the Lord in prayer and supplication. In the day of trouble and despair, call upon the Lord and he will answer, right? He is very, he loves us with an unconditional love. Without God in our lives, we are nothing, right? So thank the Lord for journey and mercy. Thank the Lord for waking up to see other day. Because without him, we are nothing, right? Without his presence, we will not be waking up, right? He is the only one who has the life hidden in us, right? So the psalm David is saying, I will cry unto the Lord despite what problems or trouble. I will hold on to him because he's my rock and he's my fortress. In him do I trust. Okay, so I hope this little short little Bible study will be a blessing to you. So let us go on to Acts chapter 15 verse 1-41. Okay, so if you have your Amplified Bible, your King James Version, your Holy King James Version, different versions of Bible, you could follow through, or you could just watch the replay. Okay, so Acts chapter 15, right? Acts is after John. Okay, so it's Acts chapter 15, verse 1-41. Okay? So Acts chapter 15, 1-41. And then we are going to do the Bible summary, and then I'll give you a Bible food for thought, right, today. And that is the end of the Bible study. Okay, so Acts. Plenty rain outside. But the sun is coming out. God is good all the time. So we're going to talk about Jesus's law, right? Is different from man's law, right? And we're going to look into depth as the reason why we have to worship Jesus' law. We have to listen and obey and trust in him. Okay, so get very wonderful today in my purple and pink today. Okay, so I hope you're all having a blessed day. Sunny days, rainy days, whatever days, but thank the Lord still in journey and mercies, because he's the one that have you waking you up in the morning. Okay, so they had a debate over the Gentiles, right, keeping the law. And certain men which came down from Judea told the brethren and said, except ye be circumcised after the manner of Moses, ye cannot be saved. Okay, so when therefore Paul and Barnabas had no small dissension and disputation. So this, let me read it as I go along and explain it as I go along to all these chapters from 1-41 in Acts 15. Okay, So God is saying, right? Debate. They had a debate. They had a quarrel, right? Between the Gentiles, Paul and Barnabas, okay? And certain men which came down. So certain men mean a some. Certain men. Certain people, right? The brethren taught in Judea. So they were in Judea, a city, right? So they came down and they talked to these men. And they were circumcised. Circumcised mean they got chastised. After the manner of Moses, he cannot be saved. So that means to say that they cannot be saved if they don't get the gospel in the thoughts and the words and deeds, they will not be saved, right? So the brethren had to go and they had outreach and they had certain men they had to teach about God's way, right? And when therefore Paul and Barnabas, okay, hold on 1 minute, right? So Paul and Barnabas had no small dissension and disputation with them. So they didn't really argue or no quarrel or nothing. They determined that Paul and Barnabas and certain other of them should go up to Jerusalem. So Paul and Barnabas had a mission to go up to Jerusalem and seek the apostles and elders about the question, because they were very curious about the question. They wanted to ask, why is this so? Or how it is. So the apostles and elders give them an answer, right? Verse 3, and being brought on their way by the church, they passed through, right, Samaria and Phoenicia, declaring the conversion of the Gentiles. So, after all this commotion, after all the questions were answered with the apostles and elders, right, they had to go back, right? Paul and Barnabas had to go, right, in the church, right? So they had to pass through some other cities called Samaria and Phoenicia, right? Declaring the conversion. So they were so happy, right? So it brings joy to the brethren that they're so happy that the people lead them to Christ, that they were baptized in the Father, in the name of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, that they were conversion. They were normal Gentiles. They had sin, right? But after a while, when the brethren talk to them and preach to them about the word of God, they get down on their knees and repent and surrender their life to the Lord. And they allow God to change them. So conversion means converting to one religion to other religion. It means that they are changed and they are sanctified by the blood of Jesus. Okay? They were not in their old ways from prayer. They were in their old ways from prayer, but they converted. So the brethren were so joyous and so happy. They were praising and worshiping them. Right? And verse 4, and when they will come to Jerusalem, they will receive of the church. So the church received them by baptizing them. They were baptized, right? And of the apostles and elders, and they declared all things that God had done with them. So God was in the midst of it all, despite whatever was going through, right? God was in the midst of the apostles, the elders, Paul and Barnabas, and these people, the brethren, who the certain men, they were preaching. And they came to a conclusion, they came to the senses that God is the one in control and God lead them into the right direction, right? But there arose up certain of the sect of the Pharisees which believed, saying that it was needful to circumcise them. So circumcise means to punish them, right? And to command them to keep the law. So they were so stubborn and so ignorant that the Pharisees them believed that they thought it was needful to do that. They thought they could go and be incarcerated, right? But God had to spare them. They had to repent. They had to do some work for him, right? They had to listen. God sent these people like the brethren and like the apostles and elders to help them out too. And Paul and Barnabas was a part of it, okay? So they had to listen to the law of Moses in the Old Testament in Exodus, right? Because they were eating and drinking and marrying one another and all these things, and God didn't really like that. So God had to send these Ten Commandments, the Old Testament. But we are not no longer in the Old Testament again. We are in the New Testament, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Romans, right? We are free, right? We are free from that, okay? Because that time they were in bondage, but now we are free, right? We are free. And we are not in captivity no more. right? We are breaking, break of the yoke of the chains, right? So, and verse 6, and the apostles and elders came together for to consider of this matter. So the apostles and elders, they had a meeting, they were joyous, they are so happy and grateful that these certain men get saved, right? And God had it to give them a different lifehood. So they had it to live, they get a new beginning of life then. Okay, they were renewed by the, and transformed by the renewal of their mind. Right, verse 7, and when they had been much disputing, Peter rose up and said unto them, men and brethren, ye know, right, how that a good while ago God made choice among us, that the Gentiles by my mouth should hear the word of the gospel and believe. So they had disputing between Peter. So Peter rose up and said unto them, men and brethren, ye know that a good while ago God made choice among us. So God was with them, right, that the Gentiles by mouth would hear the word of God. So they will hear the word of God and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, right? What a coincidence that Peter had it to convince them to believe that, right? And God, which knoweth the hearts, bear them witness, giving them the Holy Ghost. So God knows the hearts of men, right? God sees and knows, saints of God, the hearts of men, because he created us in his own image and likeness, and we have to worship him in spirit and in truth. We're not supposed to be carried away by youthful lust, but give all admiration, all acknowledgement to the Lord Jesus Christ. Okay? So, and God, right? So God bear witness, right? So he had witnesses giving them the Holy Ghost. So the Holy Ghost was in them, right? And verse 9, and put no difference between us and them purifying their hearts by faith. So it didn't have no difference, right? It didn't have no difference. Despite creed or race, it didn't have no difference. All they had to do is purify their minds and hearts by faith believing. Their faith does move mountains, because faith without works is dead, okay? So God had to purify their hearts and minds and cleanse them and wash them by the blood, because they were baptized, they were renewed by the transform by the renewing of their minds. Okay? But now therefore, why tempt ye God to put a yoke upon the neck of disciples? So now they say the one temptation comes from the enemy. Okay? He doesn't like God, right? He will send people in your life to try to provoke you, to try to do you these things. Right, to give your fame, all these things, but do not take nothing from the enemy. Right, do not take anything from the enemy, because the enemy is a liar. The enemy is defeated by the blood of Jesus. Okay, so verse 10 say, so he was so enthusiastic to know why the disciples, right? So now therefore, why tempt ye God? So why it is he had to tempt God for? To put a yoke upon the neck of disciples, because they wanted to destroy disciples, that they didn't like disciples, because God assigned them to the brethren. God assigned them to the apostle elders, Paul, Barnabas, and the certain men, okay? Because the certain men was in Judea, right? And Judea is a place. That is where Israelites and people and Jews are there, right? It have mixture, okay? So they was questioning God. They was questioning as the reason why they had to go through these things. But verse 11 said, but we believe that through the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, we shall be saved, even as they. So even as the Judeans and the Gentiles and things, we have to be saved too, because for those who seek unto save that which was lost. So they were lost in the wilderness. They were once as us, right? They were once as us. Right, they were in the wilderness, so it has a process, right? But after a while, that process leads to progress. So they had it to go through all these things, because God had a plan and a purpose for their life. But it's just they had it to baptize in the name of the Father, that to wash their old man and bring forth the new man. Okay, so they will be saved through Jesus Christ, the mediator, right? The one who loves us and cares for us, saints of God. Okay, so verse 12. And then all the multitude kept silence. So everyone who knew about it kept silence, right? Because they didn't have no nation of no teeth or nothing, right? And give audience to Barnabas and Paul. So they gave a space, they gave a way to let the people hear what Barnabas and Paul had to say, because they're declaring what miracles and wonders God had done for them, right? Among the Gentiles. So what signs and what wonders? So they had it to testify, right? That okay, we bring back a report saying that the Gentiles get washed and cleansed by the blood of Jesus, and also they get abundance, and it was a miracle and a sign and a wonder. So the multitudes didn't believe in that. They believe that what they were saying, they believe on their own understanding. Okay. So verse 13. And after they had held their peace, James answered. So James was a disciple, answered saying, "Men and brethren, hearken unto me." So after all this, it was peace, right? They held their peace, mean this, the peace be still. They stand still and strong and waited until what they had to say. And James answered saying, "Men and brethren, hearken unto me." So James was saying, "Men, hearken unto me, hearken to the voice of the Lord, hearken unto me, hear my cry, listen to what I'm saying." So Simeon had declared how God at the first did visit the Gentiles. So God did visit the Gentiles to take out them a people for his name. So God visited the Gentiles for a reason. He agreed the words of the prophets as it is written. So the words of the prophet, the word of the prophets. So somebody gave a prophetic word in those days. They had plenty of prophets, right? So they had it to do that. That was God's plan for them, right? So verse 16. After this I will return and will build again the tabernacle. So I will build back my people. Which was fallen down. So it was fallen down. It was crumbling on the ground. But God restore and rebuild back the people of the tabernacle of David, right? Because he will set it up on a higher precious stool, right? That the residue of men, the residue of men, that the old man, the residue of men might seek after the Lord. So they might go after the Lord like a flood. They might overflow with blessings, because when you seek the Lord, when you seek ye first the kingdom, according to Matthew 6:3, when you seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, all these things will added unto you. So when you seek the Lord first daily, and you put him first, and you wash and you cleanse by the blood of Jesus, and you forget about the old man, the residues of your life, right? You will be able to focus. You will be able to see the blessings and the miracles, signs and wonders. Because when you see the signs and wonders, you know that God loves you, right? So saints of God, we need to wake up. We need to understand that God loves us. And we need to seek him. We need to seek after the Lord. Don't seek after man, but after the Lord, right? And all the Gentiles upon whom my name, right? So the Gentiles, them had it to wake up. They had a calling, right? So known unto God, verse 18, are all his works from the beginning of the earth. So God created the heaven and the earth. God created us in his own image and likeness. And he loves us with an unconditional love. So unto all the works that God did for us, we have to be thankful and grateful, right? Because his presence is new every morning. So wherefore my sentence, verse 19, in Acts chapter 15, right? Wherefore my sentence is that we trouble not them which from among the Gentiles are turned to God. So we, in time past, some Christians slip and fall, but we as Christian people had to know what we are about in Christ, because we are a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. And we have to be new and be new in Christ. Okay? So what God wants us to do, right, is to turn from our wicked ways and turn to him. Okay? So verse 20, right? But that we write unto them that they abstain from pollutions of idols and from fornication and from things strangled and from blood. So God is saying, right, that we have to abstain and refrain from. We have to abstain from pollution. We have to not go back in our kind of lust. We're not going back and worshiping no graven images. We're not going back and doing fornication and doing all these things, witchcraft and all these things, right? We are cleansed and washed by the blood. We have to be acting as the Lord Jesus Christ. We have to be like representations, leaders, spiritual leaders, prophetess, prophets in the blood of Jesus, and stand on solid ground, okay? Because if we go back in our ways, do not lean on this time. You can trust the Lord. Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust the Lord in all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In ways acknowledge him and he will direct your path. Okay? So verse 21 said that for Moses of old time had in every city them that preach him. So in Moses in the Old Testament, right, coming back to the old time where Moses was a Jew, Moses was a Hebrew, okay, that he preach him, right, and being read in the synagogues every Sabbath day. So every Sabbath day, every Saturday, they will have synagogues coming and will have this old time of Moses, right, in every city preaching, right, outreach on these things. Verse 22. And then please, right, and then please, verse 22, and then please aid the apostles and elders with the whole church. Okay? So, then please aid the apostles and elders with the whole church to send chosen men of their own company to Antioch with Paul and Barnabas, namely Judas, Sirmene, Barsabas, and Silas, chief men among the brethren. So, the apostles and elders and the whole church, right? They had it to go. They send the chosen men. So the chosen men were Paul and Barnabas, right? Judas, Sirmene, Barsabas, and Silas. So they added on other men that were chosen, okay, among the brethren. And they wrote letters by them. So they had it to write letters. Write letters about the testimony, about the wondrous works what God did for them, okay? So they had it to write these letters regularly to send, right? Because in those days, they didn't have no cell phone, right? They didn't have no cell phone. They had the old telephone, but they didn't have no cell phone in them days. They had to write letters like telegram and all these things. Okay? That's all I want. Okay, so. Looking very good to me. I just changed my venue. So, and they wrote, right? They wrote letters by them after this manner, the apostles and elders and brethren. Send greeting unto the brethren which are of the Gentiles in Antioch. So they say greeting in the name of Jesus our Lord, our Savior Jesus Christ, the brethren which are of the Gentiles in Antioch and Syria and Sicilia. Okay? So, for as so much as we have heard that certain which went out from us have troubled you with words subverting your souls, saying, ye must be circumcised and keep the law, to whom we give no such commandment. Okay? So, they had it to hear all these things, and they had it to go out in these 2x2, right? And they had it to keep the law. They had it to keep the law of the Lord, right? They're not supposed to, because the Old Testament says that it was Moses' law, but now it's God's law, right? So verse 25 say, it seemed good unto us, being assembled with one accord. So we all as brethren have to be on one accord. We have to be together as one, love one another, be compassionate, have a Christ-minded, Christ-like-minded for people, be compassionate, pray for people, right? Adhere to what God is saying, and peace be still. And have patience and humility, right? So we have to be in one accord with the Lord, right? And assemble and be in fellowship with him. Because to send chosen men unto you with our beloved. So they send chosen men, which is Barnabas and Paul. They choose them. Because men that have hazarded their lives for the name. So men that have hazard. So hazard means dangerous. They were in old days, they were doing wrong things, they were in a sinful lust, right? The pride and ego and all these things, right? Because they have to change and they have to be converted into Christianity. And the only way you'll be converted into Christianity if you accept the Lord Jesus Christ and be in fellowship with him and baptize in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Okay? So verse 27 said, we have sent therefore, Judas and Silas, who shall also tell you the same things by mouth. Okay? So the same things what the prophet saying, the same things what Paul and Barnabas saying, the same things that the brethren and the apostle and elders was saying, the same things that Judas and Silas were going to say, right, by mouth. They're going to preach the same things. They want people to adhere what God's law is all about and the reason behind it too. Okay? So verse 28. For it seemed good to the Holy Ghost and to us to lay upon you no greater burden than these necessary things. So, the Holy Ghost does live in us when we baptize, right? So, they have to lay upon greater burden. So, they had burdens on their shoulders, and they had to lay it down for the Lord. They had to give it all up to the Lord. Verse 29, and that ye abstain from meats offered to idols, and from blood, and from things strangled, and from fornication. So, the same verse we did read prior, right? Abstain from meats mean do not eat no meat from no graven images, right? And from blood, and from things strangled, and from fornication, from which if we keep ourselves, ye shall do well, right? So if we keep away from these idols, if we keep away, if we abstain from meats that offered unto graven images, we shall be saved. But if we go back in our old ways or on a carnal flesh, we will not be saved at all, okay? Judgment will be upon us, and we will go in hell and lake of fire, okay? So I hope this really was a blessing. But number 30. So when they were dismissed, they came to Antioch. And when they had gathered the multitude together, they delivered this epistle. So when they come all together in one accord, they were dismissed. That means they will have to leave, right? Because they came to Antioch. Antioch, right, is a place, but is a name too. And when they had gathered the multitude, so they had to gather all the people and them, right, from east, west, north, and south, right, together, because they delivered the epistle, right? So which when they had read, they rejoiced for the cause. So they rejoiced. So they, just as how the brethren rejoiced that the Gentiles were saved, they had to rejoice for the consolation, right? And verse 32, and Judas and Silas, being prophets, also themselves exhorted the brethren. So they exhorted the brethren, mean that they told them that they're so happy that Jesus Christ really saved them from going to a loss, really, really blessed them and honored them, because their heart was hard from before. But as they get saved, they were different people, different persons in the body of Christ. So they had to tell the brethren how great it is to be in the presence of the Lord. Right, so they had to confirm it, and they had many words to say, because they were so rejoiced and so happy in the Lord. And after they had tarried their space, they were let go in peace from the brethren. So they had to let go in peace. They had to let go and let God. Okay? Verse 34, notwithstanding, it pleased Silas to abide there still. So notwithstanding mean they were still very, very naive too. Right, because it pleased Silas to abide there still. So the Silas had to still abide there. That means stay in a place, right? And they had to be still and peace be still, right? They had to wait until the instructions of God, right? So verse 35, Paul also and Barnabas continuing Antioch, teaching and preaching the word of the Lord with many others also. Paul and Barnabas continued in Antioch, a place. They're teaching and preaching about the word of the Lord. They're telling everybody how God is provider, sustainer, how God loves us, and we have to focus him, we have to worship him, we have to magnify and praise him, because he's majesty and high, right? So they did a missionary work, okay, for the Lord. So with many others too, not only them alone, but with many other people who like them, okay? So verse 36, and some days after, Paul said unto Barnabas, let us go again and visit. So they had an idea. So after the preaching and teaching, right, amongst the people, they had to go and visit the brethren, the same brethren, right, in every city where we have preached the word of the Lord and see how they do. So they had to check upon them. They had to make a visit, make a turn, and check upon the brethren in each and every different countries, okay, or states or whatever, all right? Because they want to know if they wanted to know that is brotherly love, right? And Barnabas determined to take with them John, whose surname was Mark. So John, whose surname was Mark, right? They had to determine to take John with them along the trip, along the journey, right? For the preaching and the teaching of the Lord Jesus Christ, right? In different cities too, right? verse 38. But Paul thought not good to take him with them who departed from them from Pamphylia, and went not with them to the work. So, but Paul thought not good to take them. So Paul had double-minded, right? Paul thinking, well, okay, I could take John, but I had somebody else in mind, right? So they had to depart from the countries and go from there, and went not with them to the work. Okay, and the contention was so sharp between them that they departed asunder one from the other, and so Barnabas took Mark and sailed unto Cyprus. So they had to depart from one another, right? So Barnabas took Mark, and where Paul was, Paul maybe take somebody else and went and ride or get a drop somewhere. Okay, in those days they had caddies and this stuff, right? And sail, they had boats too. So sail unto Cyprus. Cyprus is our other city, right? Verse 40. And Paul chose Silas. So after that, Paul chose Silas. So Barnabas took Mark and sailed unto Cyprus, and Paul chose Silas and departed. Departed means to leave, being recommended by the brethren. So the brethren recommended them to, okay, I have a friend, I could choose this friend. This friend is for me. I'm going with Silas to preach the word of the Lord. I don't study what Mark doing. Once Mark and Barnabas get themselves in order, I will be at check. I will still check them. I had to check the brethren and the elders too and see how they're going. That's what Paul was saying, right? But Paul had to do it unto the grace of God. It was always God's glory, right? It's not for their own, but for God's glory, okay? So, the last verse, 41. And he went through Syria and Sicilia, confirming churches. So after all of this run around, after all, they check the brethren, they check the elderly, they check the people and them who really talked to them from beginning, right? Paul and Barnabas had it to go. They had to go through Syria and Sicilia, confirming. So they had to confirm the churches that they love the Lord Jesus Christ, that they are not prideful, right? They are respecting God's law. They're respecting. It's not about man's law, right? The reason why we have to obey God's law is because God's law is different from man's law. We have to obey what God say. We have to be peace, be still, right? So I hope this little Bible study on Acts chapter 15, verse 1 to 40, and will be a blessing to your hearts. But now we are going on to the Bible summary, right? But hold on 1 minute. Hold on 1 minute, okay? Hold on. So I hope you all love this Bible study, Spidey moving around. But God is good all the time. All the time God is good. Okay. So the Bible summary is all about the Acts 15, right? Verse 1 to 41 read. I hope it will be a blessing. God wants us to live under his law, not man's law. Right? That was the Old Testament, but now we are in the New Testament. We have to be transformed. We have to be new vessels. Right? We have to be new vessels for God to fill us with the new wine that he has prepared for us. Okay? So, now we are going on to the Bible summary. Right? Will take on 1 minute. Hold on. Something full. So, hold on 1 minute. So, things has happened for a reason, but thank the Lord, God is good all the time, and all the time God is good, okay? So, the Bible verse by topic, right? The New Testament Bible study, right? In Acts, the book of Acts, right? We'll explain very, very deep, and then we are going on to the food for thought, okay? So, the author, the book of Acts does not specifically identify its author, but Luke 1, 1 to 4 and Acts 1, 1 to 3, it is clear that the same author wrote both Luke and Acts. The tradition from the earliest days of the church has been that Luke, a companion of the Apostle Paul, wrote both Luke and Acts, right? The purpose of writing it, the book of Acts was written to provide a history of the early church. Okay, so the emphasis of the book is the importance of the day of Pentecost and being empowered to be effective witnesses for Jesus Christ. Acts records the apostles being Christ's witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the rest of the world, surrounding the world, right? So, reading the book of Acts, right, the book sheds light on the gift of the Holy Spirit, who empowers, guides, teaches us, and serves as a counselor. Reading the book of Acts, we are enlightened and encouraged by the many miracles that Jesus Christ performed by the disciples Peter, John, and Paul. The book of Acts emphasizes the importance of obedience. So, saints of God, we have to be obedient to the word of the Lord Jesus Christ, okay? And not stumble in our ways, but focus on Him. Right, so as a result of the word of God, it will transform us and the importance of obedience. So Acts emphasizing what it is to be a Christian, right? A true born-again Christian, right? So the lust for power, greed, and many other vices of the devil are evidenced in the book of Acts, okay? So the brief summary, right, of this whole Acts 15, 1 to 41, what we just read and explained, right? The book of Acts gives the history of the Christian church and the spread of the gospel of Jesus Christ, as well as the mounting opposition to it. Although many faithful servants were used to preach and teach the gospel of Jesus Christ, like Saul, whose name was changed to Paul, was the most influential. Before he was converted, Paul took great pleasure in persecuting and killing Christians. Paul's dramatic conversion on the Damascus Road, Acts 9, 1, to 31 is a highlight of the book of Acts, right? After his conversion, he went to the opposite extreme of loving and God and preaching his word with power, with fervency and the spirit of the true and living God. The disciples were empowered by the Holy Spirit to be his witnesses in Jerusalem. Chapters 1, 8 to 3, okay? Judea and Samaria, chapters 8, 4, 12, 25, and to the ends of the earth, chapters 13, 1 to 28, including in the last section, Paul's three missionary journeys, 13, 1, 21 to 16, his trials in Jerusalem and Caesarea, 21, 17, 26, 32, and his final journey to Rome, 27, 1, 28 to 31. Okay? So, the connections now. The book of Acts serves as a transition from the old covenant of law keeping to the new covenant of grace and faith. This transition is seen in several key events in Acts. First, there was a change in the ministry of the Holy Spirit, whose primary function in the Old Testament was the external anointing of God's people, among them Moses. Okay? So So Peter's vision of the sheet is Acts 10:9-15 is another sign of the transition from the old covenant, right? So the Jew, the new covenant, unity of Jew and Gentile in one universal church, no longer under old covenant of law. So we are not under the old covenant of law. We are the new wine, the new vessels, transformed, right? Because God cleansed us and washed us by the blood of Jesus. So we have to be renewed. We are new covenant of grace through faith in the shedding blood of Christ on the cross, okay? So, the practical application. God can do amazing things to ordinary people when he empowers them through his spirit. God essentially took a group of fishermen and used them to turn the world upside down. Acts 17:6. God took a Christian hating murderer and change him into the greatest Christian evangelist, the author of almost half the books of the New Testament. God used persecution to cause the quickest expansion of a new faith in the history of the world. God can and does do the same through us, changing our hearts, empowering us by the Holy Spirit, and giving us a passion to spread the good news of salvation to every creature. If we try to accomplish these things in our own power, we will fail. Okay? Like the disciples, in Acts 1:8, we are to wait for the empowerment of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit. Then go in his power to fulfill the Great Commission, Matthew 28:19-20. So this is to say, saints of God, we have to focus on God. We have to be like a great commissioner for the Lord Jesus Christ, a great physician too. We must have the Holy Spirit in us, because without the Holy Spirit in us, we are failing, right? So I hope this Bible summary, you could go back and take down the scripture verses and read and summarize these things, because it will be it will be helping you in your daily lives, helping in your holy life with God and walking with the Lord. Okay? So I hope you all love this. Okay, so let us go now on to this book, right? I'm going to read, and then we are going to go, right? So, born anew, right? We have to be renewed by the renewing of our minds. So born anew. This does not mean what Nicodemus thought it did, or that which so often is found in pagan philosophies and myths, that an old man is born again as a little child, or that he is rejuvenated so that he becomes a young man. A newborn child has the same nature as its parents, not a bit better. Said the son of a fallen Adam was after the image and in likeness of his sinful father, Genesis 5:3. Job already said, who can bring a clean man out of the unclean? Not one. Job 14:4. And Romans 5:19 tells us that all Adam's descendants have been constituted sinners by his disobedience. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and which is born of the spirit is spirit. John 3:6. Even if Nicodemus would have been born again 10 times in the same way he had been born the first time of sinful parents, nothing would have been changed as far as his relationship to God was concerned. A man must be born anew, or from above in an entirely new manner, from a new source of life. The Lord Jesus tells us in verse 5 what this source of life is. Verily, verily, I say unto you, except any one be born of water and of spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. In the scriptures, water is the well-known type of the word of God. So if we don't have the water, the word of God, right, to feed upon our lives, the Holy Spirit, we are nothing. We cannot enter in the kingdom of God. We must be born of the Spirit and born of water, right? And born of the Spirit means the word of God will apply to all men by the Holy Ghost, right? Ephesians 5:26 tells us this expressly, and likewise John 13:10 together with John 15:3. Water cleanses that to which it is applied. The word of God applied by the Holy Spirit cleanses the inclinations, the thoughts, and the actions of man. And at the same time, the Spirit is using the word to work out a new life in him. So we have to be encouraged, motivated, and inspired by the blood of Jesus, right? We have to allow the Holy Spirit to come and enter into our lives for a new life to form, okay, and transform, okay? So, we, which is born in flesh is flesh, and which is born in spirit is spirit, right? So, we have its character. We have to have a changed character, changed mindset, and love the Lord with all our heart, okay? So, let us pray now. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this little short Bible study, despite the rain, despite whatever, Father Lord, is happening. Father Lord, you rest assured, Father Lord, that people all around the world in America and Caribbean will listen to me, despite the interruptions or whatever, Father Lord. But Father Lord Jesus, I thank you, Lord Jesus, for coming to your presence on every day of my life, Father Lord. I'm about to go, Father Lord, I pray that people have a blessed day, Father Lord, wherever they are in the world, Father Lord, those who are working, Father Lord, those who are helping out the children at home, Father Lord, I pray, Father Lord, your blessing, Father Lord, let them focus and renewed by your renewal of mind, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord, amen. So I hope you all have a blessed day, right? I hope you all have a blessed day, okay? I'm looking very, very wonderful today. And my shoes. Okay, but you have a blessed day. You have a blessed day, a blessed weekend, and I will love you with the love of Jesus, and I'm praying for you always, okay? So, I'm praying for you always, all the time. Focus on the Lord. Allow God's presence to work in your life. Despite the interruptions, despite whatever, we came through the Bible study. We came through every single thing today because God wants to do a new work in your life. If you just focus, if you have the Holy Spirit, if you are determined, right, the Holy Spirit is going to, God is going to open new doors in your life, right? But just trust the Lord all the time. And he will direct your path, okay? Let me sing this song. Trust the Lord with all your heart, and he shall direct, and he shall direct your path. In what ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct, and he shall direct your path. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. And lean not on your understanding. In ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. Okay, so you have a blessed day, right? Love you with the love of Jesus, right? I'll see you all on another video, right? I just want to shout out to Mr. Justin, right? I pray you have a blessed day, man of God. I will always be praying for you all and other people, right, Miss Yolanda, right, and other people who I know. Love you all with the love of Jesus. I'll be praying for you all. I pray for everybody, right, but God is opening doors for you in your life that no man can shut, okay? So love you with the love of Jesus. Have a blessed weekend, and bye-bye. See you all Monday. Bye.